My interest in the guitar as a boy grew out of admiration for my cousin Jack Marshall. He is a studio guitarist and musician in Los Angeles, and this just happens to be his arrangement of this traditional folk song of Spain.
A few years ago, Andre Segovia, undisputed world master of the classical guitar, named four younger men to whom he looked for the preservation and furtherance of the tradition to which he had given his life. One of them, Christopher Parkening, is our guest today on Camera 3. He was 19 when Segovia prophesied his fame. He had been playing the guitar since he was 11, studying first with Celedonio and Pepe Romero, and later with Segovia himself. A student at UCLA and at the University of Southern California, he now teaches the guitar at USC and maintains a heavy schedule of concert and recording dates. A few years ago, when his youth and extraordinary talents would have made it easy for him to attract the label of child prodigy, Christopher Parkening declined many offers to appear publicly, choosing instead to mature himself as an artist. And it is indeed the mature artist we hear today in this selection of works from four centuries of the guitar, solo pieces as well as a splendid contemporary work for guitar and orchestra written for Segovia himself by Joaquin Rodrigo. In this first group of solo pieces, we travel backwards in time from the 19th century Spanish master Isaac Albéniz to the 16th century composer Alonso Mudara and a Bach chorale transcribed for guitar. Thank you.
Much of guitar music was written for its predecessor. The instrument is the vihuela. The composer Mudara wrote for this instrument, and this fantasia is really quite unusual for its time. The beginning of the piece starts with a harp-like sound, which was intended by the composer, and the second section of the piece has much dissonance in it, and down below the music he has inscribed that if played well, it will not sound too badly. Bach, Jesu Joy Man's Desiring was transcribed for the guitar by Rick Foster, a friend of one of my students. He has tried to preserve the original bass line in the music, and this makes this piece one of the most difficult in guitar repertoire.
Joaquin Rodrigo composed his Fantasia para un Gentilhombre for Andres Segovia in the fall of 1954. The themes reflect some of the lighthearted dance and folkloric melodies collected and reworked in the 17th century by the lutenist Gaspar Sanz from Aragon, who was employed by Philip IV of Spain. This was an age when the Spanish guitar was in great vogue all over Europe. Christopher Parkening is heard now with the CBS Chamber Orchestra under Alfredo Antonini.
Many guitarists play this Fantasia Concerto by Joaquin Rodrigo, which was written for Segovia. None of them plays it quite like Segovia himself. Whenever I play it, that's what I aim for, his level of performance. Thank you. I enjoy playing with orchestras, but for me the classic guitar is really a very intimate instrument. This next piece is often attributed to Sylvius Weiss, a lutenist and a contemporary of Bach, but was really composed by the Mexican Manuel Ponce. He liked to write in the styles of past masters. It is a pity he didn't take credit for it in his own lifetime. Thank you.
The critics agree that Christopher Parkening, still an extraordinarily young man, has a brilliant career ahead of him. Perhaps the greatest compliment has come from Donald Hanahan, who wrote in the New York Times, "His playing is so intelligent, sensitive, and adept that one can forget everything but the music." Until next week, this is Jim McAndrew for Camera 3.
I used to be nervous playing for large audiences, but now as the audiences get larger and larger, I find that nervousness being transformed into a genuine feeling of excitement.